Hi children, good morning. This is your Tajari sir, Maths teacher. In our previous class, we have discussed about sets, definition, and in my last class, the types of sets we had starts, that is empty set, singleton set, universal set, subset, proper subset. Today we are going to start the basic operation on sets. As we have in numericals, the basic operations like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. In the same manner, in the theory of sets, we have some different operations. So those operations we are going to discuss now. The first one is union of sets. The name itself gives clear idea that union, combine. The set which consists of all the elements of A and B. The set which consists of all the elements of A and B is known as union of these two sets. And it is written as A union B. We have to read as A union B. So union means we have to write together, or two sets elements we have to write together. For example, here I took one set A 4, 5, 8, 9 and B is the set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now these two sets I am going to find A union B. Well, finding A union B, now we will write all the elements. Together we will write 4, 5, 8, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As we have, a set should not have any elements repeat. So the set doesn't allow the repetition. So here some elements are comes repetition. So the elements which are repeated that we will remove. Here 4 and 5 are repeated. So we will write only once. That means set of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 9. So A union B means we have to write all the elements of A and B together. So the condition of writing set is the element should not repeat. So that here 4 and 5 comes twice. So we removed one time and only we took the second time, one time only. And now this is, if you observe the elements of A union B. The elements of A union B are, so here A elements also is there and B elements also is there. See, A elements 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And B elements 4, 5, 8, 9. 4, 5, 8, 9. So the two sets together, if you write, we call it as A union B. There is one formula we have. Formula in the sense, if an element, if an element X is belongs to A union B, if X is belongs to A union B, which means this element is belongs to A and also B. So X is belongs to A union B means, suppose if an element in A union B means, it must be X is A, sorry. So it must be X is in A or X is in must be B or in both. If X is belongs to A union B, means this element either in A or either in B. Or in both also. So here x belongs to A union B means x either in A or in B. The next operation is intersection of sets. Intersection. Here intersection means the set of elements which are common in both A and B. Common. The elements which are common in both sets A and B is known as intersection of A and B. It is written as A intersection B. This one we have to read as intersection. It is a reverse of union, that is U. For example, here I took two sets. A is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and B is 2, 4, 6, 8. Now I want to find the intersection. Intersection means, just now I said, common element. So the elements which are in common in both, those elements only we have to write. Now 1 is not in the set, so 1 we won't write. 2 is there, that means 2 is common in both the sets. 3, so 3 is not there. 4 is there, so 4 is common element. 5 not there, so that means A intersection B. So in these two sets the common elements are 2 and 4. So this is known as the intersection of two sets. Here as we learn A union B, the same manner the formula we can get, if X is belongs to A intersection B, if any element in A intersection B, then we can say that X is belongs to A and X is belongs to B. So this is a formula for intersection. So if an element belongs to A intersection B, then X must be in A and as well as in B. The next operation is difference of sets. Difference means subtraction. Here the set of elements which are belong to A but do not belong to B. Here it is important, belong to A, do not belong to B. Then we will say it is the difference of the sets A and B, and we can write as A minus B. To understand this, see the example. So example A is, I took first 5 natural numbers and B is the set of first 4 odd numbers. Now A minus B. A minus B. What I said, the elements which are belong to A only. That means the elements of A we have to write. If any element of B comes, we have to remove. That's all. Now 1. So 1 is there in B. So that 1 we won't write. Because of it is belong to B too. So we have to write only the elements of A here. Now 2. 2 is not there. So it is only belong to A. 3. 3 is belongs to B. So that we are removing. 4. 4 is not there. That means 4 is belong to only for A. 5. Yes, 5 is also in B. So that we will remove. So the elements of A, only 2 or 4. The remaining 3 elements are belong to B. So that we remove those elements. So this set of numbers we call it as A minus B. So here one thing you can observe. In A minus B if we have any element, these elements are only belong to A. So like formula. If X is belongs to A minus B. If X is belongs to A minus B, then we can write X is belongs to A and X is not belongs to B. Just now I said A minus B elements mean only the elements which are belongs to A only. So here X is belongs to A minus B mean this element is only in A but not in B. A small note here. If two sets are having no common elements, Here no common elements means they are different elements. They have the different element. Then we will say the two sets are disjoint sets. Disjoint sets means if two sets are have no common element, different elements, then they are called disjoint set. To understand, just here see the first one, A is first three odd numbers, 1, 3, 5. And second one is 2, 4, 6. This is first three even numbers. Now, is there any common elements in both? In both the sets, is there any common elements? No. That means the A intersection B, we will get an empty set. There is no common element. So, which implies A intersection B is equal to 5. So, what is my intention to tell? If two sets are disjoint, then their intersection is empty set. Let us start exercise 2.2. The first question they given, if A and B, these are two sets, find A intersection B, B intersection A, and also are they equal? They are asking us to whether we have to see are they equal. First one, A intersection B. So A elements, intersection, B element. Intersection means the elements which are common in both the sets. 1. So 1 is common in both. So 1. 2. 2 is also common. 3 is also common. 4 is not there. That means 1, 2, 3. These 3 elements are common in both A and B. Similarly, B intersection A. Set of B elements, intersection set of A elements. 1. 1 is there. 2, 3, 5 not there, 6 not there. That means set of 1, 2, 3. These 3 elements are common. If you observe A intersection B and B intersection A, they both are have the same element, which implies A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. So we have to write yes. Yes, A intersection B is equal to B intersection A. The second question. They given A is set of 0, 2, 4. We have to find A intersection 5 and A intersection A. And we have to write the comment on the result. Now A intersection 5. A means a given set 0, 2, 4. 5 means, as we know, it is an empty set without any elements. Now the intersection means the common element. Which elements are common? So, is there any element common in both the sets? No, there is no common element. That means A intersection 5 is empty. So, which tells us that A intersection 5 is always 5, an empty set. So once again I will repeat, so A is any set and 5 is an empty set. So the intersection of an empty set with any set is always an empty set. And next one is A intersection A. A is set of 0, 2, 4 and again. Now which elements are common? 0 is there, 2 is there, 4 also is there. So these elements are nothing but the set of A, which gives the intersection of the same set is the set itself. So A intersection A is always A. So the third one what they given is the set of A elements 2 to 10 and 3 to 15. They are the odd numbers, here some even multiples of 3, here multiples of 2 they give. We have to find A minus B and B minus A minus B. A minus B means what I said before, the elements which are belong to A only, not belong to B. That means the elements of A we have to write. If any element of B in A, that we have to remove. 2 is not there, so we can write 2.
4 is not there, so 4 we can write. 6 is there, so 6 we have to write. 8 not there, so 8. 10 not there. So these are the elements of A minus B. Similarly, B minus A. The elements of B only we have to write. First one, 3. In A element not there, so only 3 we have to write. 6 is there, so we have to remove that element 6. 9 not there, so we have to write 9. 12 not there. 15 not there. So the elements of only B we have to write. If any element of A, that we have to remove. Now you can observe clearly, A minus B is 2, 4, 8, 10. B minus A is 3, 9, 12, 15. Are they same? They have any same elements? No. So by this what we can conclude, A minus B is not equal to B minus A. So I hope you understood the difference of two sets is not equal when we change the order. A minus B and B minus A are not equal. Now here I would like to give a small work for you. The same exercise 2.2, the sixth Roman. The sixth Roman, you have the finding the difference of the two sets. Those the sixth Roman try to do in your home.